And then, time tactic number five is to remember to take a Sabbath day of rest. You know, some people think that time management is all about cramming more stuff into an already overloaded schedule. Folks, that's not good time management. Good time management is about finding the right balance in all the different areas of life. And when it comes to this matter of balancing work versus rest, you know what? God has already clearly established for us what the proper ratio of work to rest should be. And He did it when He established the principle of the Sabbath day. Think about this for a moment. Why did God work 6 days and then rest one day? Was He tired? No, God doesn't get tired. He did that as an example for you and I so that we would know the proper ratio of work to rest. 6 days of work, one day of rest. And yet, you know, whenever you start talking about this matter of a meaningful observance of the Sabbath day, somebody automatically think, wait a minute, that's legalism. You can't talk about that because we're not under the law. We're under grace. Well, you know what I say to that. This matter of observing one day in seven as a day of rest is not just a matter of Old Testament law because it goes back before the law. You know, it goes all the way back into creation week. Again, God did that for us as an example of our proper ratio. But again, this is just becoming such a forgotten principle in American culture today. I know my own thinking has changed a lot over the last 30 years that I've been a Christian about how to observe the Lord's Day. When I first became a Christian, I didn't really have any belief of doing much different on Sunday other than that was just the day I went to church. But shortly after I became a Christian, I went to a very conservative little Bible college, and they had a rule at the school that you were not supposed to do your schoolwork on Sunday. They wanted it to be a day of either rest, worship, or service to other people. And I went down there as a new Christian, and I said, well, that's silly. I mean, I came down here to take Bible college classes, and they're telling me not to even study on Sunday. I'm not going to pay attention to that. And so I'm sorry to say, I studied 7 days a week, and didn't make very good grades, by the way. Well, I went back to the university where I had been attending when I met the Lord and finished up my degree there the following 2 years. Then I went back to the Bible college for the second time. Now, when I went back the second time, I still didn't have any conviction it was wrong for me to do my schoolwork on Sunday, but I had discovered during that time a principle of Scripture of obedience to authority, which told me that if it was God's will for me to go to that school, it was also God's will for me to obey the rules of that school, whether I completely agreed with them or not. So as a simple matter of obedience to authority, at 11:59 on Saturday night, I closed the books. And I didn't open them up again until 12:01 Monday morning if I needed to. Now, somebody might think, what's the difference between 11:59 Saturday night and midnight Sunday morning? Well, here's what happened. At 11:59 on Saturday night, when I closed those books, a feeling of rest came over me, which I never could experience when I was trying to work 7 days a week. And it was at that point I realized what Jesus meant when He said, man wasn't made for the Sabbath was made for man. See, that was a gift He'd been trying to give me all along, and I was rejecting it by trying to work 7 days a week. Our great-grandfathers called it the Holy Sabbath. Our grandfathers called it the Sabbath day. Our parents called it Sunday, and we call it the weekend. Well, no matter what you call it, I think if you look at it in a historic context, you'll see that the church of our day has greatly departed from what our forefathers understood in this matter of the Lord's Day. So let me just encourage you, make a Sunday your homeschool-free day, and I guarantee your kids won't buck that rule, most likely. So they'll give them the full day off on Sunday, and you take it off as well.